Just, you know, doing something. music store. And I've asked them to make me a little deal on an audio set. This might be a little technical, but I'm going to tell you what I'm going to buy. Because I enjoy little things like that, you know. The more you work in film, the more you start to realize that audio matters a huge deal. And I should know, because I've been making these little videos for you. So, that automatically gets you into the world of audio terms. But again, I like it, so I'm going to try to tell you what I've bought. So first of all, I've decided to go with an audio interface, the Roland Cubix 24, which is a little audio interface with two channels, left and right. And the wonderful thing about that is, right now, after every video, I have to go into my sound post-production program, and I have to compress the audio, which is basically tuning down the high peaks a little bit and raising the quiet bits automatically, so that the sound is more even. So you can hear this more properly. The sound of my voice, which takes up the bulk of the audio spectrum in the raw recording. But this little audio interface does that for me, so that I can hear what I'm going to use for the video. I like that. Okay. That's okay. Let's try it. Now that's a decent brew for the early morning. Decided to go with the Rode NTG5, which is a matched pair of directional microphones. I've got XLR cables, two of them, of course, leading into the audio interface. That means that the cameras will most likely be off screen while you still hear the same sound as you would right now with the binaural effects. So that's pretty cool as well. Some microphone stands and shock mounts, of course. All in all, it's a pretty decent set. Of course, I'm mostly going to use it for ASMR videos, but I've justified the purchase by saying to myself and others that I'm going to use them for interviews, for documentaries as well. Because I've been researching the proper ways to do an interview for a documentary. And as it turns out, in the new web style of documentary, you do a separate audio interview without any cameras. Let me take a sip of my coffee. You'll notice this as well when you look up little portraits on Vimeo, for instance. If you like that sort of thing, I would really recommend you watch Through the Ground Glass by Taylor Hawkins. You'll notice that he has interviewed his subjects without ever showing their face. This gives you such a clear audio signal. You know, the interview quality is beautiful. These little microphones will do the same because they have a really low noise floor. Right now you might be able to hear a little hiss in the background. You won't have that after this new little audio set. So yeah, I'm pretty excited. I'm always excited when I get to purchase new film gear. Technology is developing so fast that every couple of years, you know, you can completely renew a camera set to have it up to standards. Like 4K, for instance. You're watching this in 4K. Like the quality. It won't be long before that's going to be the broadcast standard. You can watch the news in 4K. It's going to happen. Yeah. I've been researching documentary, which is going to be a big documentary about myself, probably going to be feature length as well. I'm writing the script for that right now. It's going to be about the Ironman triathlon. Those of you who don't know what that is, it's known as the world's toughest race, with good right. It's like every triathlon, swimming, this race uses Olympic standards, so it's going to be 3.8 kilometers of swimming, which would be about 2.5 miles, then 180 kilometers or 110, 120 miles of biking. Have to be completed in under 17 hours, if I'm right, if I'm correct, yeah, under 17 hours, and if you're able to do that, you gain the title of Iron Man, which I believe has nothing to do with the Marvel character. Race. Because of my father. He died about 2.5 years ago. Such an impact on my life and that of my siblings and my mother, of course, that we had to pick up a lot of the things that he used to do around the house, and I've tried to fill in on a lot of those. Which you can never do properly, of course, but you know, someone ought to try to. But yeah, we didn't really have the best bond, but one thing that he had as a standard in his life was always work hard, to always be hard on himself. And the only area in life where I think that is necessary is in sports, in physical activities. You know, you can never get any further until you push yourself. And that's something that he could appreciate for the last few years. So I thought, when I'm training for an Ironman, I'm going to push the limits, you know. It's going to be an extremely tough ride. And that way I'm going to uncover all the emotional baggage that I've been dragging along, and at the same time I'm going to, in a way, prove myself worthy to my dad posthumously. I think that's going to be a decent documentary. Emotional reasons as well, of course. Because don't be fooled, I would never do this if it wouldn't make a great movie, great documentary. But everyone I've pitched it to so far thinks it's a good idea. But those are usually my friends and family, so another sip of my coffee before it gets cold. But one of my friends, who is also a filmmaker, says that he wants to do filming. That way I can completely focus on training and directing. That's going to be a challenge to direct my own emotional journey, you know, because there are a lot of basic story structures that you can follow, but, you know, they never fully apply to real life, and if you try to force your own story into a story construct, you're yourself to court, as we would say in Dutch. You'd fall short on yourself. And that's something that I want to avoid at all costs. What have I been talking about? My evening, the new audio setup that I'm going to build here, a little bit about film, a little bit about my Iron Man documentary idea, what else is there? so I'm told. Do correct me if I'm wrong. About this ASMR channel yesterday. If I'm right, none of them know what my YouTube name is yet. I don't think I'll tell them anytime soon, because right now I can still do whatever I want without feeling any form of restriction. Self-censor. None of that. Which is also why I'm still not doing a face reveal. Because I don't want the restrictions. But maybe when the Iron Man documentary becomes a hit, that's the time to let you in on that bit of fun as well. I think it's only fair. Because weekly videos while training for an Ironman are going to be filled with Ironman related stuff. Exercise. And then it's weekend again. Well, I hope that you have enjoyed this little ramble. I know I have. I always like letting my mind flow in the early morning. And let me know what you think about the documentary. Of sleep.